I don't think that the mushroom zombies are here to get us. I think that's a really, it's a fun show, but it does really emphasize that fungal disease is important. It's a big problem for our patients in the hospital, and it's going to continue to be a problem with the growing immunosuppressed group and sort of the effects of climate change on fungal disease spread. Cordyceps is really a pretty interesting fungal pathogen. It's primarily in ants, and it basically affects their brain in such a way that they sort of clamp on to different grass structures and sort of stay there, or leaves, and sort of stay there to recapitulate their life cycle, to be ingested by another organism and sort of continue the cycle around to help with their replication. It does grow out of them. Those are sort of scary pictures, I think, and probably the premise behind how The Last of Us was envisioned. It's very interesting to look at. It's a little scary. And we see those certainly in ants and a number of other different sort of insect species. So I think it's interesting to talk about and to look through, but really not a risk for us. A lot of different fungi really have a particular thermal barrier, a temperature that they like to grow at. And some people think that our human body temperature has evolved specifically because of fungi, and we're just too warm for the vast majority of fungi to grow. We definitely have seen climate change affect different fungal pathogens around the world. We have several that have emerged, newly emerged, so Candida auris would be the example for that. We do think coccidioides, the fungus that causes valley fever, has also moved throughout North America as a result of climate change. And then Sporothrix, an infection primarily in Brazil, has moved from plants to cats as a reservoir. So we do think that that's occurring with some fungal pathogens, but we don't think those that affect primarily insects are going to skip all the way to mammals. We do like that the show has brought so much attention to fungal diseases, because they've been quite neglected historically over the last 30 years. Fungal diseases are tough to treat. They're eukaryotic organisms like us, and so the toxicity of the agents we use to kill these fungi also have a lot of side effects for our patients. So the most important thing really is prevention. So patients at highest risk, like our leukemia patients or patients receiving a lot of immunosuppressive therapy, we do really counsel them to avoid things that would place them at high risk for fungal infection. And some of those patients are at such high risk, we put them on medications to prevent infection.